Hi there, this is Unmesh, and today I'm going to share with you a super simple trick to fill hair gaps in Photoshop. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the brilliant world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo or any other photos shown in the tutorial, check the links in the description. Before we begin, we need to understand the concept of Lighten Blend Mode. If you simply create a new layer by clicking on the new layer button right there, and then choose the brush. And by the way, guys, this is just for demonstration. You don't have to do it. All right. Now, let's change the blend mode of layer one from normal to lighten. All right. Now, with the brush selected, let's sample a color. Let's sample this color. Now, if we paint, see, the paint is not appearing on the areas which are brighter than the sampled color. And the paint is appearing on the areas which are darker than the sampled color. And that's what the Lighten Blend Mode is. If we choose the Lighten Blend Mode, it's like saying to Photoshop, either lighten it or don't do anything. So if you can lighten it, lighten it. If you cannot lighten it, don't do anything. So if we choose a darker color by sampling here, and if we paint on most of the areas, the paint won't appear. Why? Because you cannot make anything brighter or you cannot lighten with a darker color. And that is the theory of the Lighten Blend Mode. So how can we use it here? Have a look at the hair gap. What are hair gaps actually? So the hair gaps right here are dark. So does that ring a bell? We need to lighten it. So let's create a new layer by clicking on the new layer button right there again. And this time, let's name this hair gap. And now take the clone stamp tool right there and make sure the sample is current and below. Now let's zoom in with a soft brush, take a sample from a nearby area and paint over the hair gaps. Now keep in mind, we have to just lighten it. In other words, we have to just bring back the hair on the areas which are darker. So let's change the blend mode of the hair gap layer from normal to lighten. Now let's do it. So take a sample from a nearby area, something like this, and paint on this area. So that way, it's only filling up the dark areas. Let's take a sample from here and fill this area up just like this. Beware of the pattern. Sometimes when a hair pattern shows twice, it gives the viewer a sign that this one is definitely cloned. So beware of that. Now let's fill up these areas as well. Well, that was easy. You don't have to do all of the areas. Have a look here. Maybe I'll fill this up. Fill that up as well. Fill this up. That was fine. We didn't have to do that. Over there, probably this area, just a touch. Now, once you have filled in these areas, you might think it's kind of too much. So all you got to do is simply decrease the opacity. So I'm going to keep the opacity at somewhere about, let's go for 40% or 45%. See the difference. Here's the before, here's the after. It looks so much better. Let us move on to our next example where we want our hair to be perfectly aligned. So here's example number two. Have a look at this. We want the hair to be perfect, but there are some gaps right here. So we got to use the same technique. Simply create a new layer. Let's name this hair gap, hair gaps, fill, or whatever you want to name it. This is just for organization. Change the blend mode from normal to lighten. Clone stamp tool selected. It still has the sample of the previous image. So we need to take the sample from this image now. Keep in mind, you have to consider the depth of field. So you cannot sample from this area because this area is out of focus. And the hair gap that we are trying to fill is a little in focus. So please try to sample from a nearby area with a similar focal plane. All right. So we're going to sample from right here. And don't worry about sampling from dark areas. The Lighten Blend Mode will take care of it. It will only lighten. All right, let's take a sample from this area and just simply fill it. Well, that was easy. Now here you see a pattern. That's what we are scared of. So let's take a sample again from there and try to cover it. All right, now that area is taken care of. Now if you want to fill in these areas, you can if you want to just... And by the way, if you want to create separate layers, that can also be done. So if you want to control the opacity of this one and you want to keep it just about 59, that's okay. Now create a new layer and this might be the second one for a different area. So for different areas of the hair, you can create separate layers with different opacities. So let's do this area. Let's take a sample from here, nearby area, and fill it just like that. Here as well, we're going to take a sample from here and fill that. But that area is not looking right. You know why? Because the blend mode we selected is normal. Change it to lighten. Now it will fill in those areas. All right. Now let's take a sample from here. Fill in that area. That looks filled in. Now let's try filling in this area. Well, that was easy. That area as well. Now we don't have to completely fill all of the areas. It might look a little fake. So opacity is always your best friend. So don't worry about it right now. Later, we're going to decrease the opacity anyway. And that is why I asked you to have different layers for different areas, because you might want different opacities for different areas. All right, let's see. This was pretty quick. I didn't take much time for it. So here's the before, here's the after. So easily we have filled all of these gaps, but those gaps did bring a little dimension. So decrease the opacity. See, 47, or let's go for 45. Let's have a look at the overall before and after. Here's the before, here's the after. You see how easy it was to fill the hair gaps? So that's how to use the Lighten Blend Mode to fill hair gaps in Photoshop. All we have to keep in mind is the concept behind it. Once you have the Lighten Blend Mode selected, it will only paint on the areas which are darker than the sampled color or the sampled area. That's it. It will not paint on the areas brighter than that. That's all you got to keep in mind, and that's it. And in this, what we did was create a new layer. Name it if you want to, hair gap. Let's take the clone stamp tool and make sure the sample is current and below. Change the blend mode of the hair gap layer from normal to lighten. And then take a sample from a nearby area and paint on the hair gaps. And that's it. And do not forget, opacity is your best friend. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thanks so much for all your support. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.